ओके, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू एंड वेलकम फॉर दी फ्रेश वीक। फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू इंटरैक्ट विद ईच अदर रिगार्डिंग दी फर्स्ट ईयर सिलेबस, एस्पेशली दी सेम वन सिलेबस इज कंसर्न्ड। एंड टिल देन लास्ट वीक, till the last week we discussed about the general characters of fungi, economic importance of fungi, and the diseases caused by fungi, and at the same time the two life forms type studies under fungi allotted as per our syllabus, that is the life history of the Rhizopus and Puccinia. Rhizopus is a saprophyte and Puccinia is a parasite. Puccinia is a parasite and both of them, they cause disease in animals. And Puccinia causes rust diseases on the grain plants like wheat and barley and rice, etc. And apart from this, we also discussed about the general characters of bacteria and bacterial classification and the structure of a bacterial cell, and which we are going to know or discuss once again, and bacterial beneficial activities and bacterial harmful activities, is it not? And at the same time we learnt about the general features of bryophyta members, so, and two of the type studies, Marchantia and Fusaria, and their life cycles. And as a final touch to the bryophyta members, we also read and we also discussed the evolution of bryophytes, the evolution of sporophytes in bryophytes. And in today's class, though it is a discussed one, and I am going to deal with so very important question, the general characters of algae. General characters of algae. So what are these algae? What are these algae? Algae are the calophytes. Calophytes. So what is meant by calophytes? The plants which bear a plant body which is not differentiated into root system and shoot system. Root system and shoot system, and such type of plant bodies are known to be calli, or plant body is called thallus. And these calophytes, hence they are known to be calophytes. These calophytes, they have chlorophyll pigments. Due to the presence of these chlorophyll pigments, they can prepare their food materials by themselves. They can prepare their food materials by themselves. Hence, they are autotrophic. They are photosynthetic. In turn, they are known to be autotrophic. And lack a sterile covering of cells around the reproductive cells. So it is not that much of an important point. So normally in higher plants, which we come across in the bryophyta members, the reproductive organs are covered by, especially the archegonium and antheridium, they are covered by sterile layer of cells, which is known to be sterile jacket layer. It is known to be sterile jacket layer. Okay. But here, in this case, the sterile jacket layer is absent in the very in the algal members, because they are very primitive. So according to some of the assumptions, or the theories, it is said that they are the first formed life or living organisms on the first formed earth. భూమి మీద భూమి ఏర్పడిన తర్వాత ఏర్పడినటువంటి లేదా పుట్టినటువంటి మొట్టమొదటి జీవులు అని కూడా వాటిని చెప్తారు. సో దే ఆర్ వెరీ ప్రిమిటివ్, దే ఆర్ వెరీ ప్రిమిటివ్. అండ్ ది వాట్ ఈస్ దేర్ హ్యాబిట్ అండ్ హ్యాబిటెట్స్, వాట్ ఈస్ దేర్ హ్యాబిట్ అండ్ హ్యాబిటెట్స్. సో నార్మలీ దే ఆర్ ఫ్రీ ఫ్లోటింగ్. సార్ ఆల్గే జనరల్ ఫీచర్స్ చెప్తున్నాను సార్. Okay, so regarding their habit and habitat is concerned, habit habitat ante enti, vaati deha aakruti mariyu aavasa sthanamu, avi ekkada nivasistuntayi. So they may be free floating, free swimming or attached to the bottom in the shallow water. According to habitat, algae can be classified. So that means, so first let us see where they are living. They may be free floating on the stagnant water, slow running streams, ponds, ditches.
Good morning.
Good morning, Rasekar.
Kodi late hai sir, chain lo pan unta.
Era.
Kodi late hai sir, vachhe ki.
Polani ki point va.
No, avun sir.
Okay, 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 okay. Kan le. Right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right, so regarding the habitat is concerned, that means where they are living, whether which type of life. So what is the type of surrounding?
సార్
ఎనీబడి దేర్
నుంచి పెద్ద నదుల్లో కూడాను ఈ ఆల్గే కనిపిస్తాయి. అంటే నీటిలో నివసించేటర్. సో లెట్ మీ షో సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది పిక్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆల్గల్ మెంబర్స్. See? So among these aquatic algae, freshwater algae are separates, marine water algae are separates, and shallow water, saline water algae are separate. And here you are observing freshwater algae, Volvox and Chlamydomonas. Volvox and Chlamydomonas, freshwater algae. So let us turn the screen in this manner so that we can have a good picture. See, Chlamydomonas and Volvox. Volvox is a colonial form. Volvox is a colonial form. The Volvox, each and every cell of this Volvox, they appear, their structure is like this only, like the Chlamydomonas only, each and individual cell, they live in colony. They live in colony, that is colonial form. So these Volvox and Chlamydomonas are the freshwater life forms. See, stagnant water algae. Okay, nilabadinatuvanti nilalo perigetuvanti algae. AV Idogonium and Chara. Idogonium and Chara. So these are the, so basically aquatic, and in aquatic habitats, again, freshwater algal forms are separate, and the stagnant water life forms are separate, and the saltwater life forms are separate likewise. So these are the Edogonium and Chara and some other life forms, algal members, they live in stagnant water. They live in stagnant water. So the running water algae. So usually they grow in the slow running streams. Chinnaga parutunde 20 ee chinna yerlalonu akkada chinna vankallo perugutu untai. And examples are Cladophora and Eulothrix. Cladophora and Eulothrix. See, the green color structure which we are observing in the cells, that is chloroplast. So here in Eulothrix, you are observing the chloroplast, just like in case of Spirogyra, which you have studied in intermediate. Spirogyra. The Spirogyra has the chloroplast, which is spirally arranged inside each and every vegetative cell, and hence its name is Spirogyra. So here in case of Eulothrix also, the appears like this, the spirally arranged the chloroplast is observed. See, sea water, that is marine water algae. Marine water algae, Ectocarpus and Porphyra. Ectocarpus and Porphyra. See, sea water, that is marine water algae. Marine water algae are Ectocarpus and Porphyra. So planktonic algae. So it is known to be phytoplanktons. They are called as phytoplanktons. These are found free floating or freely swimming in water. They may or may not attach to any substratum in the water, and just they are floating on the surface of the water freely, or they may be attached. Cyclotella and Pinnularia, they are known to be diatoms. So the second one is known to be Pinnularia is a diatom. Okay, so then euplanktons. The euplanktons are a special category of algal members which lives in water, free floating on the surface of the water, but these are never attached to the substratum. Never attached to the substratum. See, tycho plankton in the beginning of their life they gets attached, but later they get detached, they become free. So the cylindrospermum, this is a cylindrospermum and this is the Rivularia. Cylindrospermum and Rivularia at initial stages of their life or the development, they are observed that they are attached to the substratum, and after their to some extent they remain attached to the substratum or the rocks present in the water or the other plants present in the water, and whenever they completely developed, they gets detached from the host and they are free living, they are free floating. Okay, they are the algal members which initially attach to the substratum and afterwards they gets detached. They are known to be tychoplankton. Terrestrial algae means they will not directly grow on the land, not in the normal soil, just they present on the found on or beneath the soil surface. Example, Trentifolia species. So that means especially in the moist soil only, on or beneath the soil. So these are aerophytic algae. They are adapted to the aerial life, occur on tree trunks, moist walls, flower pots, rocks, etc. Okay, they will not live in the water, just they are adapted to the life on the aerial life. Especially they may occur on the tree trunks, in the deep woods or deep forests, moist walls, flower pots or the rocks. And cryophytes. The cryophytes are the algal members found on mountain peaks with snow. The mountain peaks ante Himalaya parvata sikaralu ala untayi kada, alanti sikaral meeda manchu ekkadaithe kappabadi untundo alanti place lo undetuvanti ee algal members ni స్నో ఆల్గే లేదా క్రయోఫైటిక్ ఆల్గే అంటారు. దే నోన్ టు బి క్రయోఫైటిక్ ఆల్గే. హీమోకోకస్ నివాలిస్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్, హీమోకోకస్ నివాలిస్ అండ్ క్లామిడోమోనాస్ ఎల్లో సోనియన్సిస్, గ్రీన్ కాలనీస్. యు ఆర్ అబ్జర్వింగ్ హియర్ గ్రీన్ కాలనీస్, దే ఆర్ ది కాలనీస్ ఆఫ్ క్లామిడోమోనాస్, దే ఆర్ ది క్రయోఫైట్స్. సో దెన్ థర్మోఫైట్స్. So thermophytes are the special type of algal members, just like thermophilic bacteria, which lives in hot springs, tolerate temperature up to 85 degrees centigrade. So ivu 85 degrees centigrade la varaku kuda nu vedini tattukongalavi hot springs lo manaku kanipistayi. And examples are haplosiphon lignosus. Here you are observing the thermophytic algae, the pictures of thermophytic algae. Halophytic algae, so which lives in water containing high percentage of salt, salty saline soils or saline water, that is haplosiphon salina. Haplosiphon salina. Lithophytes, which lives on rocks. The algal members which lives on moist rocks and rocky surfaces are known to be lithophytic algae. And Gliocapsa and Rivularia. Epiphytic algae are the algae which grow on other plants. See, Sepaluros algae on chrysophyllum leaf. See, Sepaluros algae. These the white patches you are observing on the leaf. They are the Sepaluros algae on chrysophyllum leaf, and the Ordinella on mosses. Ordinella on mosses. Epizoic algae, epizoic algae. These algae are found on shells of molluscans. Mollusca yokka shells meeda, mollusca ante natta gullalu alanti untayi kada. So alanti vaati shells meeda you are observing some of the algae. The molluscans, turtles ante tabele yokka vipu meeda, and fins of fishes, and ee fishes yokka moppalu untayi kada vaati meeda. And example, Acrosiphonia. The example for epizoic algae are Acrosiphonia. See here. Endozoic algae. Endozoic algae. And these algae are found inside the body of aquatic animals. Inside the body of aquatic animals. నీళ్లలో ఉండే జంతువుల యొక్క లోపల వైపున శరీరం లోపల ఇవి ఉంటాయి. జూ క్లోరెల్లా, ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇస్ జూ క్లోరెల్లా ఫౌండ్ ఇన్సైడ్ ది హైడ్రా విరిడిస్. హైడ్రా విరిడిస్. డెండ్రాయిడ్, డెండ్రాయిడ్ మీన్స్ ట్రీ లైక్, అండ్ దీస్ ఆల్గే అపేర్స్ లైక్ మైక్రోస్కోపిక్ ట్రీస్. ఎగ్జాంపుల్ Prasinoclandus, Prasinoclandus. These Prasinoclandus, they live inside the, so normally they appears like a small trees. They appear like small trees. And then structure of algal cell. So in some of the algal cells, especially blue green algae only, they exhibit prokaryotic structure. Actually, the true algal cell, it exhibits eukaryotic cell structure. But in case of cyanobacteria, actually now it is they are treated as a bacteria, but they are regarded as a blue green algae due to the presence of the phyco the pigments phycocyanin. They appear blue green in color. But regarding their cell structure, they are prokaryotic. Okay. So this is the real structure of the eukaryotic cell of an algal member. And eukaryotic cell has the structure as in the typical cell of higher plants. All the cell includes along with protoplasm, mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosomes, and endoplasmic reticulum, all are observed in the eukaryotic cell of the algal members. Nucleus separated from the cytoplasm. So nucleus is separate. Okay, it is not just involved in the cytoplasm as in case of prokaryotics, like in bacteria and cyanobacteria. So by, and it is also, the nucleus is separated from the cytoplasm with the help of a clear nuclear membrane, and it divides by mitosis. Cytoplasm contains chloroplast, mitochondria, Golgi bodies, and endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum. And algal pigments. What type of, actually, we have green alga, red alga, brown alga. Likewise, different algae are called with their color. And how this color occurs in these algal members due to the presence of pigments. The color of algae varies due to the presence of definite chemical compounds called as pigments. And photosynthetic pigments in algae are three kinds. Three types of photosynthetic pigments are observed. They are chlorophylls, carotenoids, phycobilins, or bilyproteins. Bilyproteins. See, chlorophylls are the main photosynthetic pigments, and whereas the carotenoids and phycobilins are known to be accessory pigments, accessory photosynthetic pigments. See? So chlorophyll, I think in physiology we will get the structure of chlorophyll. Algal chlorophyll is represented by green color. So that is a chlorophyce members especially. They are fat soluble compounds. Chlorophyll is a common in all group of algae. Chlorophyll B, C, D and E have restricted distribution. Actually, chlorophyll A is common in all algal members. Chlorophyll A is common in all algal members, whereas chlorophyll B, chlorophyll C, D and E have restricted distribution. In some of the algal members only, it may be observed. And then carotenoids. The carotenoids are the fat-soluble yellow-colored pigments. They are subdivided into carotenes and xanthophylls. There may be 20 xanthophylls so far known, 20 types of xanthophylls. And carotenes are of 5 types, alpha, beta, gamma, and lycopene and carotene. Lycopene is the carotene responsible for the red color in the tomato peelings. Tomato pandu meeda paina errati rangu untundi kada. ఆ రంగు ఈ లైకోపీన్ అనేటువంటి పిగ్మెంట్ ద్వారానే వస్తుంది అండ్ విచ్ హెల్ప్స్ ఇన్ ది మినిమైజేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ ది క్యాన్సర్ రాకుండా కాపాడుతుంది. ఇట్ చెక్స్ ది క్యాన్సర్, క్యాన్సర్ సెల్స్ పెరగకుండా చేస్తుంది. దెన్ ఫైకోబిలిన్స్. ద ఫైకోబిలిన్స్ ఇంక్లూడ్ రెడ్ కలర్డ్ ఫైకో ఎరిథ్రిన్, ఫైకో సయానిన్, and likewise phycobilins include red colored phycoerythrins and blue colored phycocyanins. They are present in the members of cyanophyce and rhodophyce. Cyanophyce ante cyanobacteria annam, cyanophyce members. So they are the ante cell structure anta kodanu prokaryotic structure untundi dantlo. So they contain phycocyanin as the pigment, hence they appear blue green in color. And whereas in the rhodophyce members, రోడోఫైసి మెంబర్స్ పాలిసైఫోనియా లాంటి వాటిలో అంతా కూడాను యు మే అబ్జర్వ్ ది రెడ్ కలర్ ఫైకో ఎరిథ్రిన్. ఫైకో ఎరిథ్రిన్ యాజ్ ది పిగ్మెంట్, మెయిన్ పిగ్మెంట్. దెన్ ఆల్గల్ ఫ్లాజెల్లా. సి యు మే అబ్జర్వ్ లోకోమోటరీ ఆర్గన్స్ ఇన్ ది ఆల్గల్ మెంబర్స్ ఆల్సో. అండ్ ఫ్లాజెల్లా ఆర్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ ఫైన్ అండ్ హైలైన్ ఎమర్జెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది సైటోప్లాజం. Single anterior phlasm in some of the cases in pairs or many in a number, isocont equal in length or heterocont unequal in length. One may be short and one may be long. And especially the main body may not have, in some cases like a Chlamydomonas, you may observe the isocont type of flagellae, but in many of the other cases, the reproductive organs, they show the presence of the flagellum. The reproductive organ, especially male reproductive organs, male gametes, they have the presence of, in case of spirogyra or in case of the pedagonium, the male reproductive organs, they bear a tuft of flagellum. They bear a tuft of, a ring of flagellum. Okay. The nutrition, all algae are autotrophic. Most of the cells of thallus normally contain chlorophyll pigments, and the cells can manufacture their own food materials. From carbon dioxide and water through the agency of sunlight. So it is a normal process of photosynthesis. And reserved food materials, the food after its consumption, the remaining food will be stored in the form of polysaccharides. It is in the form of polysaccharides. Those are cyanophacin starch and floridian starch in rhodophyce. In cyanophacin members, it is stored in the form of cyanophacin starch, and in case of rhodophyce members, floridian starch. Deeni 2 marks kadagavachu, competitive exams lo kudanu adugutune untaru, manaku intermediate lo kudanu vachindi. Rhodophyce members, what is the form of reserved food material in rhodophyce? It is floridian starch. And three important reserve food material food are laminarin and paramyelin and leucocin. Laminarin and paramyelin and leucocin. Mannitol is also another reserve food in red algae. In red algae. All these are the notable points. And then reproduction. The nature of reproduction in algae. It may be vegetative. The vegetative reproduction is by means of fragmentation, cell division, hormogone formation, tubers, bulbils, acinates, and aplanospores. Up to acinates. See, here the fragmentation. Whenever due to the water currents, or in water bodies or water animals, due to occurring of fragmentation, it may become into small bits, one too many. And these individual bits, due to their capacity of undergoing division and having the division of labor, they can easily develop into a new thallus or new filament. And this is the binary fission type of one, very rarely observed. And this is the acinates. The normal vegetative cell secretes thick walls around it and develops into a resting spore, a resting cell. It is called as acinate. Okay. And then asexual reproduction. The asexual reproduction is by means of aplanospores, autospores, endospores and oxospores and cyst formation. Pomilla stage occurs in Chlamydomonas. Pomilla stage is occurred in Chlamydomonas. See here the spore formation. This is the spore formation. Then sexual reproduction. Here, sexual reproduction is done by means of a fusion of two specialized cells known as sex cells or gametes. And the sexual reproduction may be isogamous or heterogamous. It means the union, the fusion may take place in between two identical gametes or maybe two heterogamous, dissimilar gametes. See, sexual reproduction in Chlamydomonas is like this. It undergoes division. The body forms the small gametes. One may behave as male and one may behave as female. Both they fuse, zygote, meiosis, and new generation is formed. Okay. And Eulothrix life cycle. See, life cycle of Spirogyra. Beneficial aspects of algae. They provide food for human, food for invertebrates and fishes in marine culture, animal food, animal feed, soil fertilizers and conditioners in agriculture, treatment of wastewater, diatomaceous earth, phycocolloids and drugs, model system for research and harmful activities, blooms of freshwater algae, red tides and marine blooms, toxins accumulated in food chains, damage to cave plain paintings and frescoes and other work of arts, fouling of ships and other submerged surfaces, the fouling of the shells of the commercially important bivalves, so no other forms of organisms are so colorful as that of algae. Various pigments can be found in the algae. They are ubiquitous and the thallus organization contains a diversity. So due to some interruptions, so we are unable to we disconnected. So these are the some of important features of algal members, which you have to note and which you have to follow and which you have to write. So the question may be asked for 10 marks or 5 marks. So describe or explain or write the general features of algal members. Write the general features of algal members. So beware of that. And in next class, so let us discuss about the things what we have completed so far. And so from next class onwards, from tomorrow onwards, we have to follow the repetition class, revision classes only, because we don't have any syllabus left over. So we have plenty of time. And meanwhile, so from tomorrow onwards, let me take the classes in the form of a question answer type. Okay, so let me cover the first the 2 marks questions. Let me list out all the 2 marks questions and I will explain one by one, and at the same time 5 marks questions one by one and the 10 marks questions also. Okay, so that is the situation. Stay 1 minute. So I will show you some of the, once again, the pics of algae, the role of algae in the plant world. The role of algae in the plant world. Let me see. I will show you. See here. So it is due to. See. So what are these algae? They are the primitive plants. Okay, just to go on observing the. Okay. See, they vary size from nanoplankton to giant kelps, 70 meters long. Chudandi, 2 micrometers nunchi, 2 micronla nundi, 70 meters la podavu varaku kudano perugutayi. So the classification of algae, cyanophyta, blue green or cyanobacteria, prokaryotic, marine and terrestrial algae, and pyrophyta, pyrophyta class, chrysophyta, euglenophyta, they are the marine and phytoplankton, photosynthetic protists, and kingdom plantae, rhodophyta, red algae, mostly marine. Pheophyta, brown algae, mostly marine. And chlorophyta, green algae, marine and terrestrial. Marine and terrestrial. The role of these pigments is to absorb lights. So you are observing a graphic picture of the absorbance, absorption spectra of photosynthetic pigments. So according to their color. See, so in water the problem is that red and violet wavelengths do not penetrate the vertical column very well, so chlorophylls do not work well at greater depths. Algae that inhabit greater depths do so with the help of accessory pigments. These algae take on a variety of, so let me see, variety of the pigments. See, this is the brown alga, central one is the red alga, and this is the green alga. So normally chlorophyta contains chlorophyll A plus B, so green wavelength reflects. They store their product photosynthesis as a starch. Pheophyta contain chlorophylls A plus C as well as an accessory pigment fucoxanthin. See, pheophyta, fucoxanthin. So yellow and brown wavelength reflects. Store food as starch and as oil. Rhodophyta contain chlorophyll A plus D as well as accessory pigment phycobilins. These phycobilins are specialized for absorbing blue lights, which allows them to inhabit the deepest depths. See, morphology of algae. According to morphology of algae, they may be unicellular to multicellular. Unicellular to multicellular. See, this is the unicellular organism, and actually these are the colonial forms. So these are the colonies. And solitary, okay, so colonies, filamentous, unbranched and filament. See, this is the filamentous unbranched and this is the filamentous branched, okay. See, unicellular algae, microalgae, some may form colonies. Colonies are the chlorophyta wallworts. Wallworts is the best example for colonial form of algal members. Colony forms. So the filamentous form. See, the filamentous form Spirogyra. Unbranched filaments. See, branched filaments. Elothrix, and this is a cladophora. Cladophora. Multicellular and macroscopic. Sargassum, which may grow up to 70 meters. In median ocean, their clubbing may stop the huge ships. Aa area nanta kuda nu sargassasi ani pilustaru. అక్కడంతా కూడాను ఫుల్గా పెరిగేసి షిప్లు కూడా ఆపేస్తాయి. సో వేర్ డూ ది ఆల్గే లివ్? marine habitats, freshwater habits, terrestrial habits. See, both all you are observing here. The marine blooms, biome and top. See, fresh water. See, terrestrial habitats. Terrestrial habitats. See the functioning of the algae. Photoautotrophs. They help in the formation of atmospheric algae in huge number. Why are algae important? They are the primary producers, basis of food webs and forest grasses of the sea, pioneer species on rocky shores, mud flats, hot springs, lichen communities, snow algae, oxygen production and carbon fixation in aquatic habitats, and rare autotrophic organisms in extreme habitats. So examples of ecological importance of algae: red tides, other algal blooms, hot springs, kelp forests, rocky shores, ecology, aquaculture. They are very important. Cyanobacterium blooms. Extreme halophytes, which lives in saline waters, shallow waters. So, uses of seaweeds, food, hydrocolloids, and some chemical substances. Fertilizers, potential source of energy, compost by digestion, wastewater treatment. They are also used in wastewater treatment. Algae as human food. See, maniculture has become very important. See, okay, these are some of the things about algae. Let us continue.